Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So if you're limited by a ridiculously low number of ports on your Dell brand laptop or other supported brand of laptop, then you've come to the right video. In this video, I'm going to be doing an unboxing and an initial setup and taking a first look at this Dell. So this is the D6000S, or D stands for dock. This is a docking station that will allow you to connect up three external 4K monitors simultaneously, depending on your configuration, and some of your other devices as well. Without further ado, let's get this out of the box and take a first look.
Oh boy, it's Tech Timmy time.
All right, so here we are over at my unboxing station now. I've got my Viking knife out today in lieu of the bat knife. Man, this is getting like tape all over. I've done so many of these unboxings now. Careful, Timmy. Don't cut your fingers. It's definitely happened before. You don't want to bleed out during the video, right? So Dell docking station. This is, again, so this is the D6000S model, their 4K dock. I went with there's a couple different models out there. This one actually includes as part of a bundle these two Zoom speed HDMI standards, HDMI / DisplayPort standard. I went with the version that had both of these. I've never used a DisplayPort, so I'm just gonna actually try that with one of my external monitors. In terms of the box itself, so Dell is now moving, like many companies, towards sustainable packaging, which is great. So we get sort of this gray cardboard box looking thing with not a lot of marketing materials and all that, but that's fine because we're all about saving the environment here at Tech Timmy. And I'm just gonna remove these two little gazintas on the side here. So we've got a couple pieces of tape, and then I suspect, well, let's just see. So now that I remove that, does it open two ways here? Let's just see.
2 minutes later.
Another big piece of tape here. So I'm gonna go ahead and move that. On the bottom, there's actually nothing either from marketing perspective. It's just all sort of PC stuff and codes and so forth. Okay, so here we are in the box, and this is the docking station itself. So it's little. I mean, it's about the size of, what do we call that? A couple of sticks of butter, if you put them next to each other, or I don't know, maybe a little bigger than that. But it's not, you know, you think of docking stations. I had a docking station 10 years ago. It was this big contraption that you basically inserted the laptop into. That's not how they work anymore, at least not with this one. So this, yeah, let's take this off. A pretty strong piece of plastic. All right, see ya. All right, so that's going to, okay. So yeah, so I think this is going to meet my needs nicely. I'll just say right off the bat. So here is our expandability. So already we have a couple of regular USB. This USB Type-C, so a single USB Type-C port. That's important. I'll come back to that in a minute. And then we have an HDMI, a couple of display ports, and a couple more USB ports, and then also a network port as well. And then here, I believe that might be, that might be for mounting. I'm really not sure what's going on there, but so basically the idea is you connect this up to your laptop either through regular USB or USB-C, and then you are able to attach other devices using this. So basically extend your input game, if you will. So you'll have more options to connect more devices up to your laptop. In theory, if it works right. So my understanding is that I think that the preference would be, from a speed perspective, to go with USB-C, connect the laptop via USB-C, assuming you don't need, you're very limited in USB-C ports, you might be limited like me with your laptop, or try the A and see what you get for results. But the idea is you don't want this to slow you down. And that's the last thing I want, is for it to slow me down. So for today, I am going to do an unboxing, and I will leave the review for a later time, obviously, after I've had a chance to look at it. But for now, we're going to do an unboxing, and we'll also take a look at maybe setting some stuff up. And here we have one of those giant placemat documents, which I hate. I don't know why they just don't put a little booklet in here, but I guess maybe that could be part of sustainable packaging as well. And it's okay. Right off the bat, we talk about recycling. And then we have some very, very technical specs here. I'm going to set that aside for now. And then there's my little booklet after complaining about the legal one. And we have some basic instructions here. Good thing I have my readers on, because we have some very little type. Okay, and it's going to want us to download some drivers and so forth. That's all fine. Or maybe they'll install automatically when we go to set this up. But yeah, so for now, let's just get this sucker out of the box here. And then hey, look at the side. The power brick is almost the same size as the docking station. So, So I will say from a footprint perspective, I don't love that. I was hoping this would be a little bit smaller. Already I'm trying to do streamline cable management on my desk, but it is what it is. And we do have this nice wrapper for the cord here. So if you want to take it traveling or whatever, you can wrap it up like that. But wow, that is a large power brick. And presumably it's because we want to be able to have enough capacity to make these external devices as we connect them into our laptop work well, right? And then so it's the power cord. And it's a long one. All right, so here we go. So let's just see. And so very straightforward in terms of the power cord. Looks like we might have about maybe 4 feet of cable on one side, maybe even 4 feet on the other. So plenty of cable in terms of connecting this, particularly if you have, you know, you need to go far and or you have a stand-up desk. Nothing more in the box. I'm gonna set this aside for now. And then I think what I'll do is I will set this up and then we'll run through a quick setup and I'll see if I can connect at least one of my external monitors for you guys. Just to come back to the power source real quick. So this guy here, you're going to want to insert that in here firmly. Otherwise it will be loosey-goosey and it will fall out like it just happened to me. And then over on the other side, so we have this round power source here. We want to basically plug that in to the round hole in the back of the dock. And just like that. And then in terms of the footprint, I suppose you could sit them right on top of each other like that. And it's a little less dramatic. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put them on top of my desk like that. And I have a separate box for my large Dell monitor that I'll be able to put this on top of those. So I think it's gonna look nice, but I'll have to deal with some of the cable management behind. So that's the deal with that. And now next we're gonna plug it in and we're gonna take a look at doing a quick setup. So I have the dock connected to power. And I think to keep this video from going too long, I'm gonna try three things. First one, we're going to plug it in and we're going to see if the HDMI type C will do pass through where it charges the battery while the dock is connected. That is sort of critical from my perspective because I only have one HDMI port in this and I need to be able to charge my laptop while I'm working. So that's a key piece. So we'll do that first. And then I'll also take a look and see if I can't connect up one of my UPC external hard drive to this. USB type A external hard drive to this and see how that works and see if it recognizes it. And the third thing I'll do is I will connect an external monitor to show you guys how that works. I'll try the display port and then also we will use the fast cables that they gave us, but I'll try a display port and also an HDMI port to see what that looks like. So, all right. So first one, as I said, I'm going to set these aside here and this might be a little bit less organized than some other videos because I have multiple devices and a very small workspace here. But so I pulled off the USB type A and I want to use USB type C for the connection. My understanding is that will be faster than using the A. So I really do want that. So I'm going to take the laptop up here and I'm going to stick it in my one USB type C slot that I have in my laptop that is typically used for charging. Now I'm hoping I will hear a little ding. And yes, so let me zoom in. And so right down here, it says that it's charging and it's charging weekly. That's okay. I've actually seen that when I plug in a couple of different charging cables I'm using here, it will still charge even in weak state, which that works for me. And if you guys know anything about that, drop a comment down below because I'm interested to hear your thoughts. If weak charging is actually a bad idea, I feel like it's been totally fine. I've had this laptop for better part of 6 months now, and I've been weak charging all the way through, and it seems to work great. So that's cool. So that's very encouraging. Now, the next thing that I wanted to try is I have this little USB dongle here that I use to transfer a lot of my video files. So one end sticks into the phone, the other end sticks into the PC. This is the USB-C right here. And I know the lighting's not the best, guys. Sorry. I'm going to just stick this in here, and then we'll see if the drive shows up on my computer. Wait for it. So far, no. And then there it is. So very encouraging. So this is actually going better than I had hoped. And I have not had to install any special drivers or anything else. Of course, I do have a Dell laptop, and this is a Dell docking station, but that's the drive right there. So it just worked. No additional software required. So this just seems to be working exactly as I had hoped. And let's just prove it out. Let me see if I can get to my files here. And nice and zippy. So that is, I got a ton of video files in there, and that came up nice and fast. So already I have, this works as an external USB-C while I'm charging using my one USB-C port that's attached to my laptop. Now this guy, I'm gonna pull it out. Drive goes away from my directory there. And now I'm going to, this dongle also has a USB type A attachment. Is that the right side? It is, this way. So it also has a USB type A. So let's try that as well with the docking station, see if that works. And if it doesn't, well, I think that's fine because I really plan to use the USB. All right, so here we go. USB A is in there. Come on. And it dinged and dinged again, and there we go. So it did work. Excellent. So now I have, if I decide that I want to use this and leave my USB-C port open for something else, I'm able to do that. So sweet. This is exactly why I bought this. So basically, again, we're extending the port game on the laptop. Next, I'm going to grab my external monitor, and I'm going to change the camera view again for you guys to pull that out so we can take a look. I'll try the display port cable and then also an HDMI cable and see what that looks like in terms of speed. All right, so I grabbed my external monitor out of the other room, and I have one end of the display port cable connected into the monitor already. And now the moment of truth, I am going to attach the other end of the display port into the one of the two display port jacks here in the dock. And make sure it's facing the right way. There we go. And moment of truth, will the monitor come on? And yes, it does. Excellent. So that's exactly what we would want to see. I'm going to call it my display settings again here, and we'll just go right to display. And then, so there we have it in the nice order as well. So we have the bottom one, which is number one. So that's my laptop. And I'll just show you, if we say identify here, it will show you which is which. So there's the bottom laptop is number one, and the top is number two. And they're organized nice where I can just slide the mouse up here. And just for sake of completeness, open up a web browser, and I can take that browser off the laptop, put it up onto full screen here, and there you go. So that is exactly the behavior that we want to see. And what I love most about this is that I still have, on the other side here, I still have an open USB-C port, which I was concerned that basically once I plug the dock into the laptop via USB-C that I would have no ports whatsoever, but that is not true. So I still have the spare port. And then potentially I could also experiment with USB type A to see how that would work. And then I would have both USB-C ports working. But so the performance, I did an initial test before lighting this up for you guys, and the performance seems great. It's totally fine. So zero lag. I'm connecting my laptop to the dock via USB-C, and I'm using a zoom speed display port cable to go from my external monitor to the docking station. I don't even have a display port cable on this computer, so very cool. And then presumably the same thing would work with HDMI. So again, I went with basically Dell had an option when you buy the dock, you can also order some cables with it. So I did go with that option. And these zoom speed cables seem zippy. They seem really good. At least the DisplayPort that I'm one of them using now. I will try the HDMI one next, but this video is already running long, so I get it. I will try the HDMI one next. So this is working just as it should, and I'm excited to get this into my workflow. Basically, I'm trying to streamline my whole operation for creating video. So this will actually help me because I will not just have the external monitor, but I'll also be able to use that little dongle thing that I showed you while I'm while I have that, have my monitor set up at the same time. So this should definitely make me more productive. And I also like the fact that also have a bunch of additional USB ports, and I could also hook up a third monitor via a second monitor and also a third monitor via an additional DisplayPort cable and an HDMI cable. So maybe we could set this up like Star Trek if we wanted to, essentially, with this cool little dock. I do think the more monitors you add, you will start to see performance degradation. So if you're trying to do things like game and so forth across multiple monitors, I don't think that this is conducive to that. If you have a different experience, again, drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think about this thing in general. I'm super curious as to hear if you guys have had experience, bad experiences so far. This is my first time buying a docking station literally in about 15 years. So I'm excited to use it. Hopefully this will streamline all of my sort of back and forth from the dongle to the thing, having to pull up my keyboard to the dongle and all that. It's just been super painful. So hope this video helped you guys. If it did, you wouldn't mind giving me a thumbs up. I appreciate it greatly. Unboxing and also initial setup of the Dell Universal D6000S 4K dock. So again, hope this helped you. Hope to see you in the next one. Cheers.